Hello friends, this is Rajiv Sharma.
Here I am with you with the video editorial India, today's edition, April 11. Well, we all know Prime Minister Narendra Modi is a great politician. Perhaps the greatest ever in India. He has a knack for converting tragedies, disasters, pandemics into his favorite political situation, and how these events like pandemics or disasters or tragedies, how he converts, how he capitalizes on them. We all know that just before the elections, how he capitalized on Pulwama attack. Now, next month he is going to complete 1 year in office in his second tenure. And as we all know, the economy was nosediving. Economy was performing absolutely, quarter after quarter it was performing very badly. Unemployment. And he knew that now nationalism or Pakistan or Hindu-Muslim or Article 370 or Ram Temple, all this will not sell anymore. People will ask for economy. Now here is a godsend, COVID-19. Now, ever since February, that is, when COVID-19 started striking, rather, I would say, from mid-March, or let's make it even more specific, 25th of March, when he declared a 3-week national lockdown, in his 24th of March address to the nation. Since then, Prime Minister Modi doesn't have a cause to worry. Coronavirus may be a devil for anybody, but for Mr. Modi, it has proven to be, for others it is bane, but for him personally, it has proven to be a blessing in disguise. Because now, we all know, even if presuming that coronavirus dies a natural death or is kicked out or is exterminated, say by May or by June or even if whatever period, for long, long period, the national economy will be badly hit. So badly hit that it is highly, highly unlikely that when the next general elections are due in 2024, by then even the green shoots would not be visible. But now nobody can fault him, because everybody can see that it is the economy stupid. No, it is the coronavirus stupid. Now this is something which doesn't happen with anyone and everyone. Only a shrewd politician like Modi can direct things, can direct threats and challenges and his way and mold them accordingly to benefit him. Not only that, see, he is being praised by world leaders. The presidents of US and Brazil and the Prime Minister of Israel have thanked him personally for his gesture of giving them medicine which his own government had banned 1 week before. So this is all great showmanship. Modi the politician, the core politician as we know. So friends, now the picture is getting murkier and murkier as far as coronavirus is concerned. More and more hotspots are emerging. And as I said in my yesterday's video editorial, that it is time for not only containment zones, but also for cluster zones. And in fact, hundreds of containment zones have come up across the country. Delhi, Mumbai, Tamil Nadu, and elsewhere, which is good. Now, as far as if you look at the situation now, today, situation is far from improving. In the past 24 hours, the cases spiked by over 1,000. Total number of cases is now crossed 7,500. And then total number of deaths is also inching close to 250. But that is not the point of worry. The point of worry is this is still manageable, tolerable. What happens? Again, it is the lives versus livelihood debate. So what happens to the lockdown? Will it be lifted on 15th of April, from 15th of April? Well, now it is very much certain that after Prime Minister held a 4-hour long video conferencing with chief ministers, in which 15 chief ministers participated, and there is not a single chief minister who favored lifting of lockdown. In fact, everybody is unanimously urged him to extend it at least till 30th of April. Two states, you know that we have already done that. Odisha till 30th of April and Punjab till 1st of May. But the question is that Prime Minister, who had earlier in one of his earlier addresses to the nation, had talked about Jaan hai to Jahan hai. He had stressed on the need when he was in his March 24 address to the nation, he had stressed on the need for saving lives. Jaan hai to Jahan hai. But today he has dropped hints. Jaan bhi, Jahan bhi. That is a paradigm shift. And that will be his new template. Now, this means what? Jaan bhi, Jahan bhi. That here, Jaan is of course lives, but Jahan is economy or livelihood. So, he is talking about, now he understands the need of the hour is to shore up the economy also and not allow it to sag it beyond a point where it cannot be salvaged. So, I believe that when he addresses the nation, now, anytime, tomorrow, day after, it is for sure that the lockdown will be extended. That is surety number one, till 30th April. Surety number two is that certain sectors will be exempted this time. Certain sectors of the economy. Like, for example, Punjab and UP state governments have already exempted agri sector from lockdown because this is the harvesting season. And rightly so. They have advised the farmers, those who are harvesting the crop, to maintain social distancing. So, there are sectors like e-commerce. There are sectors like agriculture sector. These, I feel that they will be exempted. Well, before I end, let me end with just one pointer, a point of concern, Dharvi. Dharvi, the state government, the Maharashtra state government, has today begun door-to-door testing in this 1 million population, the biggest slum in Asia, in Mumbai. This is a welcome thing. Now, there are 28 cases in Dharvi. 28 cases. So, Dharvi has to be strictly watched. So, friends, here I come to the end of the bulletin. And please do let me know whether you like it or not. Do give your comments. And if you like it, kindly subscribe to the channel. Thank you.